So first of all, please allow me to introduce my good friend Gloria, who is the chairlady of WTTC, to the stage.
Hello, travelers. My name is Gloria Guevara. I am the president and CEO of the World Travel and Tourism Council, or WTTC. WTTC represents the global private sector, and it is the global authority for the economic and social contribution of travel and tourism. WTTC works with governments, destinations, and international institutions in order to create jobs, reduce poverty, and generate prosperity around the world. Travel and tourism supports 330 million jobs, which is 1 in 10 in the world, and contributes to 10% of the global GDP. Based on our learnings from the past, rebuilding travelers' confidence is crucial. So following the COVID-19 pandemic, WTTC announced safe travels protocols for the travel industry. These protocols were developed with international health authorities and will enable the industry to standardize practices across the travel experience and give consumers the confidence. I celebrate the leadership from Trip.com and their commitment for a safe and better travel. As Jane said, for Trip.com and its partners, the safety of travelers is always the top priority. WTTC is working with Trip.com and supports all initiatives that will enable travel and restore millions of jobs and livelihoods. Whenever you're ready to travel again, Trip.com Group and WTTC will be here. Thank you.
With the WTTC, Trip.com Group is introducing these new safety standards, giving you the freedom and assurance to travel on safely. Airports. Enhanced cleaning, including to self-service equipment, baggage trolleys, counters, buggies, security checkpoints, washrooms, elevators, handrails, boarding areas, and common areas, with a specific focus on high-frequency touchpoints. Provide personal protective equipment, PPE, to staff, such as masks. New signage and announcements to limit interaction and queuing at touchpoints. Possible pre-arrival health risk assessment to prevent delays upon arrival. Reduce passenger touchpoints through online check-in before departure. Use of self-check-in kiosks and bag drop. Home-printed bag tags. Greater use of biometric e-gates and boarding card reading at gates. If entry-exit screening is mandated, it should be carried out in a non-intrusive walk-through manner through full-body infrared scanners using handheld infrared thermometers and ear gun thermometers. Enhanced food safety and hygiene at restaurants with pre-packaged foods to avoid handling of food at buffets. Possible redesign of immigration halls together with governments and airlines to speed up procedures. Where declarations are required upon arrival, electronic options should be used to minimize contact, ideally using contactless process. Airlines. Provide personal protective equipment, PPE, to staff, such as masks. Reduce passengers' touch points through online check-in before departure. Use of self-check-in kiosks and bag drop. Home-printed bag tags, greater use of biometric e-gates and boarding card reading at gates. Provide approved hand sanitizers as appropriate based on high traffic areas, such as check-in and boarding areas. Revisited guidance for cleaning teams for all areas of the plane, including washrooms, as well as check-in and boarding areas, with a specific focus on high-frequency touchpoints. Consider boarding from back of the plane to the front, window to aisle. Limit movement in the cabin as much as possible. Retrain crew and frontline staff regarding infection control and hygiene measures. Tour operators. Enhanced sanitation, disinfection, and deep cleaning practices for coaches and other vehicles. Focused cleaning on high-frequency touchpoints, including handrails, door handles, tables, onboard toilets, air conditioning filters, overhead lockers, and headsets. Pre-allocated seating plans with no rotation. Limit physical contact and queuing where possible. explore staggered timing for access to venues, hotels, and restaurants, among others. Health, sanitation, disinfection and hygiene, and food safety protocols at partner restaurants. Establish with partners and suppliers, including shops, showrooms, tasting venues and shops, museums, show theatres, concert halls, factories and farms that they follow likely protocols. Convention centres, meetings and events. Implement physical distancing for seating distribution and aisles, utilising government guidance if available. Create visual support to show intent as appropriate. Reduce venue capacity limits for participants as appropriate and required by local legislation. Distinguish between different areas of risk in the venue. Consider pre-arrival risk assessment questionnaire for participants. Limit physical interaction and possible queuing at reception and registration, using advanced registration to enhance participant flow. Create isolation units outside the venue where possible for those showing COVID-19 symptoms. Hospitality. Revisit guidance for cleaning teams for all areas of the hotel with a specific focus on high-frequency touchpoints such as room key cards. Ensure social distancing for guests through signage and guidelines, including lifts. Retrain staff in infection control, social distancing, and enhanced hygiene measures, including hand washing and the use of masks and gloves. All extraneous items should be removed throughout the hotel. Integrate technologies to enable automation, such as introducing contactless payments where possible. Offer room service using no-contact delivery methods. Have clear, consistent, and enhanced communication with customers on new health and hygiene safety protocols, both digitally and physically at hotels. Safe reopening of food and beverage outlets and meetings and event spaces with specific actions to ensure social distancing, disinfection, and food safety. Retail. Deep cleaning regimes. Staff should be fully familiar and trained in the new policies, including social distancing, the use of thermal scanning, and the wearing of face masks. Social distancing should be observed in stores through special visual markers. Minimize touch points by introducing digital maps, digital queue management, e-menus, virtual personal shopping, and roving concierges. Promote contactless payments and email receipts wherever possible by providing complimentary Wi-Fi to encourage take-up. Hand sanitizers at shop entrances and exits, as well as intervals inside premises and in bathrooms. In cafes, restaurants, and other food outlets, all menus to be available digitally. Special attention placed to seating and queue management in line with social distancing requirements. Capacity limits should be introduced in retail car parks to prevent overcrowding. With these comprehensive standards in place across the entire travel industry, now's the time to travel on safely with Trip.com Group and the WTTC.